Hi, my name is Mike, and I'm one of the product managers for Blackbaud's Education Management System. In today's video, I want to take a look at a redesigned faculty end-of-term grade entry experience that we have for you. Before we talk through the enhancements that are packaged in this update, I want to take a moment and talk about grade translations. Grade translations have a lot of functions, but one very important function that they house is the ability to take numeric grades and output label values instead. For example, instead of showing 95% on a transcript, through a grade translation, you can display an A label value instead. When this new experience is turned on, the calculations we use will interact with grade translations a little differently than they have in the past. Because of this, I want to take a moment and say that however many decimal places your school uses while calculating grades is the same number of decimals that you want to include in your grade translation. As a good rule of thumb, you'll want to go out 5 decimal places in your grade translation to ensure that all grade values are able to be calculated. Just to show you an example, here we have a grade translation. We have our grade labels on the left. We can see our minimum values to the right of that. And then over on the right, we've gone ahead and made sure that we had at least 3 decimals in our maximum value. Again, if your school wants to make sure that all grade values are always included regardless of the decimal precision, you'll want to make sure that this maximum value on the right-hand side goes out at least 5 decimal places. Now that we've discussed the update to grade translations, let's talk about the new feature and what you can expect when it has been turned on for your school. There are 2 big enhancements we've made with this update. The first is the ability for faculty to see previously recorded grade plan grades within the grade entry grid. This way, faculty can see how students have been progressing throughout the year without needing to run progress reports or lists to see these values. The second enhancement comes in the form of a new grading workflow for our traditional grades, called the narrative view. The narrative view was built with long-form comment writing in mind, giving faculty more data points to look through while writing comments, and introducing auto-saving so that work isn't mistakenly lost. Outside of the 2 big updates that I mentioned earlier, we have a couple of minor enhancements as well. The first of which is an update in the form of the bulk comment modal. Faculty can now select which students the bulk comment will apply to, and they can easily see which students already have a comment. That way, they don't accidentally override any previously written individual comments. All comment text boxes now auto-save, whether you're working in the list or the grid view. That way, faculty never lose their work. Group types that previously did not have grading tabs on their group pages, like athletics, will now be able to access grading. They no longer have to go to My Day, Schedule, and Performance to begin the grading process. And finally, the calculation wizard, when pulling gradebook grades into the end-of-term grade entry screen, has received a more streamlined workflow. This should make the calculation setup easier for faculty as they go and they calculate their end-of-term grades. If your school uses Mastery, we're also making some big updates to that module as part of this update as well. For example, you're going to be able to link Mastery skills to assessment skills. That way, faculty, when they're entering end-of-term grades, can pull Mastery grade values out of the gradebook and put them into those assessment skills without needing to manually do the grade entry. A couple of other features with this, faculty will be able to calculate either marking period averages for skills or year-to-date averages for skills. Parent skills that are mapped will average all subskills, and we'll take a look at an example of that in the demo here in just a little bit. In addition, we've introduced a couple of new imports that allow you to quickly map Mastery skills to assessment skills via import rather than having to do it manually. And again, we'll take a look at that here in the demo in just a bit. All right, so let's go ahead and take a look at the new feature. I've gone ahead and logged into one of my sample environments, and I'm impersonating a faculty member. When it's time to enter in grades, faculty will continue to go to classes, open up the class that they want to enter grades for, and from here, they can choose to either continue using the old experience as they have, or they may select the new grading experience instead. In the new grading experience, they'll get access to 2 views, the grid, which is what we're looking at here, or the narrative view. We'll first take a look at the grid view. In the grid view, we have different grade plan grades, some of which are grade plan grades, meaning that they take label or numeric value, and some of them are comment grade plan grades, meaning that they introduce a text editor that the teacher can then insert some sort of a comment to display on report cards or transcripts. If a faculty member wants to be able to see previous grades, they'll come up here and click Show Previous Grades. From here, they get an option to choose which particular grades they want to show. So we'll go ahead and show quarter one and quarter two grades. And from here, we have our two columns in a view-only state. So faculty can only view the grades in the past. They cannot edit them. In addition, faculty can also view previous comments. So we'll go ahead and add those here. For the faculty member to see the comment, they simply need to click the comment icon. And from here, they can go and look at all of the comments for the various students in that particular grade plan grade. If a faculty member wants to manually add a grade value for a student, all they have to do is find the grade plan grade that they want to grade, find the student, and then click on the dropdown or the text input and add in the numeric or letter grade value that they desire. So for Betty, we'll go ahead and add in an A-. In addition to letter or numeric grade input, teachers can also add comments for students. So long as they have access to a grade plan grade that is marked as a comment, they'll be able to add or edit comments for individual students. From here, they simply click the Add or Edit button and add in their comment into the text modal. They can also resize this text box now, again, allowing for longer comments to be more easily read. In addition, we do have two bulk methods of entering in grades from the grid view. We have calculate grades for letter and numeric grade input, and bulk comments. First, let's take a look at bulk comments. Teachers can come in here and now select which students the bulk comment will apply to. In addition, teachers now see a comment icon, letting them know which students already have a comment. That way they don't accidentally override work that they have already done. So we can go ahead and unmark these comments for these students and then add a comment here. Once the faculty member is ready, they can click Save, and that will add that comment to the given students that were selected. In addition, the Calculate Grades modal has also received an update. Now, when faculty members click Calculate Grades, they're going to see something a little different. We've constructed a three-step wizard here. First, faculty will select which students they want to calculate grades for. From here, they click Next and will then select their calculation. If your school has predetermined calculations already configured for this particular grade plan grade, faculty will not see this option and instead will just see a dropdown of the formula that you've already constructed in school year setup. Otherwise, if no formula exists within school year setup, faculty will be able to construct their own. Here they can select their decimal precision, choose whether or not to include rounding in their output, and then they can include which grade values they want to use when calculating grades. From here, the faculty can either choose from previously recorded grade plan grades, from values from their grade book, or values from their assignments in their grade book. We're going to go ahead and use quarter four for right now. The faculty member will then add what percentage they want to assign to that particular value, and then click Next. From here, the faculty member will be able to review their grade calculation. On this screen, they'll be able to see how many decimals they utilized, whether or not rounding was selected, a sample of their calculation, and one student to show as an example, just to make sure that the grade calculation is going to do what the faculty member expects. In addition, we have some error messages that we'll show here in the event that the faculty member has some students that meet certain criteria, and we'll take a look at those error messages in just a little bit. Next, I'll go ahead and click Finish, and that will go ahead and add my grade down the list. Here we can see that Bryce has a grade of 95. This is his calculated true value. The faculty member can still come into the adjusted grade column and adjust the grade to whatever they need or desire. Should they want to round up Bryce's grade, the faculty member has control in order to do so, while keeping the integrity of the calculated grade in a view-only state here. In addition, teachers will continue to have access to things like previous report cards and transcripts, and they can see which of their students have learning profiles. Clicking on the student with the learning profile will allow the teacher to generate that learning profile, given they have access to it. Teachers can also see a student's individual gradebook by clicking on the student's name and then clicking See Student Gradebook. From here, the teacher can see the assignment types that the student has been graded on, and clicking on an assignment type will display the student's assignment grades. The teacher can also switch between the grid and the narrative view via this toggle in the upper right-hand corner. Clicking on the narrative view displays the students on the left-hand side. In the middle of the screen, we can see the specific grades for one given student, and to the right, we have a helpful pane with some additional information for the faculty member to consume while they're writing or grading students. For example, we'll take a look at Bryce. Here for Bryce, we can see his grades, his calculated grade value, the adjusted grade that will display on the report card or the transcript, and we can see the comment text modal here. Instead of having to click to open the modal, in the narrative view, the text modal will display by default. This text modal still auto-saves for faculty members, that way they don't lose progress. On the right, we can see gradebook information for the current marking period. We can see previous grades and previous comments. And if your faculty are allowed to see attendance, the faculty member will be able to see the attendance for the given student. If a faculty member would like, they can click on one of these assignment types or the cumulative value here to pull up the student gradebook. The new faculty grade entry experience has also been updated when entering in assessment skills. For courses that have an assessment grade plan attached to them, faculty members will be able to come to the new grading tab to access the new grade entry experience for assessment skills. On the left, the faculty member will find the student names. Clicking on a student name will allow the faculty member to insert skill evaluations and comments for that given student. Simply clicking on the dropdown, selecting the desired value, will automatically score that student. On the left, we're also surfacing some helpful information. Things like gradebook information and attendance history that were available in the traditional or standard grade experience are also available when entering in assessment skills. Faculty can also choose to show previous grades as well. Just like they could in the grid view, they can select which marking period they want to include and display, and that will automatically update in the view for all of their students. Faculty also have access to a bulk edit option. Clicking on this button will allow them to select which students they want to make a bulk edit to, and then they'll select which skills they want to automatically assign. From here, they can select which value to assign to the selected students, and then click Save and Close for it to apply. If your school uses our Mastery module, we've also made a couple of updates to how this functions. In particular, we are now allowing for assessment skills and mastery skills to be linked to one another. In order to access the new updates to Mastery, you'll want to log in as a Gradebook Manager. From there, you'll go to the Academics functional area, Grades, Grading Setup. From here, there is a new settings option called New Assessment Skills. Clicking into this will load the current list of assessment skills, and you can create new skills from here as well. For the existing assessment skills, these can be linked to Mastery Skills. The way that this works is that you'll click into the given skill, we'll click Edit, and then from here we have a Mastery Skill equivalent. Each assessment skill may only be mapped to a single Mastery Skill. Likewise, each Mastery Skill may only be mapped to a single assessment skill. In the box, simply look for the skill or type in and search for the skill that you would like to attach, and then click Save. That will create the link between your assessment skill and your content or transferable skill. Once the skills have been mapped, when faculty go to enter in assessment skills, their screen will look a little different. For example, we'll pop over to the faculty portal, We'll go to My Day, Schedule and Performance, and let's go ahead and take a look at one of our assessment grade plan groups. From here, you'll notice that a lot of the same information is true of the current experience with assessment skills. Here, we still see skills, we can add in our evaluations for those skills, and we get the helpful information on the right. But what you'll notice is now we have a calculate button for writes and recognizes numerals. This is because this assessment skill, writes and recognizes numerals, has been mapped to a mastery skill. Assessment skills that have not been mapped will not have a calculate button to faculty members displaying. Clicking on calculate will populate a wizard just like we had in the grid view of the standard grade experience. From here, faculty can select which students they will be evaluating the skill for. They can select which gradebook value they want to utilize. If they select a quarter or a marking period value, that will only give an average of the skills within that marking period. If they select cumulative, that will give a year-to-date value for that particular skill. We're going to go ahead and use the cumulative value, and we'll say 100%. Afterwards, the faculty will hit a review screen where they can see how the calculation is being constructed. From here, we can see the decimal places, the assessment skill, the transferable or content area skill equivalent that the assessment skill is tied to or mapped to, whether or not rounding is included. And again, like with the standard grade experience, we can see a sample of the calculation that is being used. Here, we can see Bryce is our example student, as well as the mastery skill and the calculated grade for that given mastery skill. Once this is finished, that will update in our grid view here. So just like with the standard grades, when mastery skills are mapped, we can see a calculated column where the faculty member can see the true calculated value. And then if they need to, they can always come to the adjusted column to make any edits or adjustments that will display on the report card or the transcript. And with that, those are the updates for you for the end of term faculty grade entry experience. We hope these enhancements are things that your school have really been looking forward to for a little while. And if you have any feedback or want to chat directly with me, please by all means use that feedback link in the Activate New Experiences to go ahead and schedule a meeting so that way we can chat. Either way, I hope you have a great day and thank you again for watching.